Hello everyone. In this lecture, we are going to see what is aeration and types of aeration systems under the subject of Environmental Engineering 1. So, as you all of know, or as we have seen in previous lecture, aeration is one of the primary treatment in water treatment flow chart. So, what is aeration? Aeration is transfer of gas or removing the objectionable gases from the water. So, we are providing basically aeration for the transfer of gases and oxidizing the impurities present in water. So, let's we see the mechanism and different types of aeration systems. Aeration is the process of bringing water and air into close contact in order to remove dissolved gases such as carbon dioxide and oxidized dissolved metals such as ions. So, it is a transfer mechanism, transfer of gases between water and air. So, we are removing gases like carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, etc. from the water and oxidizing the impurities present in water. It can also be used to remove volatile organic chemicals in the water. Sometimes these are present in water. Aeration is often the first major process at the treatment plant. So, we are providing it as a primary treatment. During aeration, constituents are removed or impurities present in water are removed or modified before they can interfere with the treatment processes. So, generally, in this process, oxidizing the impurities present in water into the stable form. So, objectives of providing aeration is to remove taste and odor caused by gases due to decomposition. Next, to increase dissolved oxygen content. As you know, there are minimum requirement of oxygen, dissolved oxygen content in water for the purpose of drinking of water. Next objective is to remove hydrogen sulfide gas and decreases the carbon dioxide and raises the pH value. To remove minerals such as iron, manganese. So, because of providing aeration, the metals in form of ions, manganese, they will get oxidized into the stable form. And due to agitation of aeration, the bacteria may get killed. So, this is one of the important objectives that to kill the pathogenic bacteria and can be used for mixing chemicals. So, sometimes in coagulation, flocculation process, we are providing aeration for the mixing of chemicals. So, these are the objectives of aeration. Next, the mechanism of aeration. In which mechanism it will work? So, first mechanism is sweeping or scrubbing action caused by the turbulence of water and air mixing together. So, because of aeration, the water will get turbulent and there is scrubbing action in between water and air when they are mixing together. And next mechanism is oxidizing the certain metals in form of iron, manganese, etc. and gases. Next, the methods of aeration. So, there are basically two methods of aeration that we are providing. So, first method is passing water into air and second method is passing air into water. So, both the methods are different. Let's we see how we differ from each other. So, first is passing water into air. That means water can be exposed to air by spraying or by distributing it in such a way that small particles or thin sheet of water comes in contact with air. And water can also aerate by pumping large volume of air through the water. So, in this methodology, we are applying water in the form of thin sheet and which is in contact with air. So, gas transfer mechanism occurs in there. So cascade aerator is one of the type of aeration method which is passing water into the air, that we will see in next coming slides. And next method is passing air into water. In that method, this method creates small bubbles of air that are injected into the water stream. So in coagulation flocculation process or any oxidation pond, we are providing aeration through this method, that is passing air into water. So again, there are different types of aeration systems like air diffusers, mechanical aerator, etc., which we are providing, which are comes under this method. So next important is type of aerator systems. So aerators are classified into three types. First is gravity aerator or free fall aerator. Second is spray aerator, and third is air diffuser basins. So under gravity aerator, again it will get classified under four types, that is cascade aerators, inclined apron aerators, slat tray aerators, and gravel bed aerators. So let's we see one by one. First is cascade aerator. This is a common type of aerator we are generally used in water treatment plant. So let's we see what is cascade aerator. It can be constructed of concrete or metal. Height of this aerator system is 1 to 3 meter. A cascade aerator consists of a series of steps that the water flows over. So imagine design of this cascade aerator we will see in coming next slides. So in cascade aerator, water is allowed to fall down a number of steps by gravity. So again, these types is come under gravity fall methods. In all cascade aerators, aeration is accomplished in the splash zone. Cascade aerator can be used to oxidize ions and manganese present in water to partially reduce the dissolved gases in form of carbon dioxide and hydrogen sulfide. And large surface area of water is exposed to the atmosphere. So again, these methods come under a methodology of passing water in air. And by using this cascade aerator, we are removing 50 to 60% of carbon dioxide from water. Again, it is used in the water treatment process for various reasons, such as to remove the unwanted gases from the water by replacing them with oxygen. So we are removing basically a carbon dioxide and hydrogen sulfide and replace these objectionable gases by the oxygen. Increase the oxygen concentration in water. Remove carbon dioxide by 50 to 60% and therefore reducing the corrosive property. Remove taste and odor that are caused by dissolved gases such as hydrogen sulfide, methane, etc., which are removed during the aeration process. The process of cascade aeration is based mainly on gravity, and the aeration of this type have more efficiency due to high surface of contact with atmosphere. So this is a very effective process for transferring the gases or to increase the oxygen content in water, and which is required for the further process. It is used to increase dissolved oxygen in water and strip dissolved gases from it. So cascade aerator is a natural flow aeration which consumes less energy than force aeration system. So again, it is economical in construction. So these are the on-field images of cascade aerator. The first two images shows the circular type cascade aerator, and third one is rectangular type cascade aerator. So as you can see in this image, the water is pumped through the central pipe and water is flow in the form of thin sheet through this number of steps, so that it will get contact into air and transfer of gases, mechanism of transfer of gases takes place. This is the rectangular type cascade aerator. In this also water is pumped through this central pipe and a thin sheet of water is flow through this number of rectangular. So these are the types of cascade aerator. Next type is inclined apron aerator, which is the type of aerator comes under the gravity flow. So in this type of aerator, water falls along the inclined plane or apron, as you can see in this figure. So these are inlet trough and outlet trough, and in between these two trough a inclined platform is provided and water is passed on or through this inclined platform. The breaking up of water due to the apron causes agitation. Agitation increases contact of air and water. So this is again the type of aerator which comes under the methodology of the passing the water in air. So water is in contact with air. So transfer of gases mechanism occurs or takes place. Next type is slat tray aerator. It is consist of closely stacked superimposed wood slat tray and water is spread evenly on the top of tray. Water trickles from one tray to another. So there are layer of number of trays on one upon another and air is supplied at the bottom with the help of blowers. So diagram we will see in next slide. So airflow is in upward direction and ventilator discharges air and gases. So this is the type of slat tray aerator. As you can see, a number of trays which are placed one upon another and air is passed from this bottom and the direction of air circulation is towards the upward and water is trickle in downward direction through this number of trays and transfer mechanism takes place. The third type of gravity flow aerator are gravel bed aerator, or we can call it as trickling bed filters. So in environmental engineering too, that is wastewater treatment, we are using such kind of filter beds, that is gravel bed aerator in form of trickling filter. We are using this bed to remove the dissolved particles or suspended particles, fine suspended particles present in organic matter. So sometimes in water treatment also we are providing such kind of aerators. So in this type of aerator, water is spread at the top and it trickles down the bed of coke or anthracite. Thickness of gravel bed is 1 to 1.5 meter. So as you can see in this diagram, so it is a rectangular tank. In that filter media is placed. So generally gravel and sand particles are, or some aggregates are placed on the basis of this filter media and water is trickled through this filter media so that the attached growth process is happening there. That means the impurities present in water which are attached to this filter media, and by the provision of aeration we are providing air from this bottom and the direction of air is upward. So because of presence of oxygen or air, the biological film is formed surrounding this filter media and impurities or organic matter present in water which are get adsorbed or attached to this filter media, and in that way we are removing the impurities present in water. So these are the typical diagram of trickling bed filters. So again, in that number of trays are provided and filter media is provided in this trays and water is trickled through this filter area. Aerated water is collected from this outlet and the biological form or sludge formation is removed by the drain, by the drains. So it consists of 3-4 trays are kept filled with caulk or stone or filter media, and the thickness of bed is approximately 0.5 to 0.6 meter. The distance between tray is 0.5 meter, and water is sprayed from the distribution pipe at the top. So fourth type of gravity fall method is spray aerator. So we have seen the types of gravity fall aerators. So next type is spray aerator. So these aerators are applied in the course of water treatment for absorption of oxygen and desorption of gases. So again, the mechanism is same, that is gas transfer. In this type of aerator, water is distributed into air in form of small droplets by means of nozzles mounted on a stationary pipe system. It required relatively large area to collect the water. This type of aerator has one or more spray nozzles connected to a pipe manifold, that is main pipe. And moving through the pipe under pressure, the water leaves each nozzle in a fine spray and falls through the surrounding air, creating a fountain effect. So again, this type of aerator comes under the methodology of passing the water into air through the nozzles. Next type are spray aerator. So in general, spray aeration is successful in oxidizing iron and manganese. This type of aerator has one or more spray nozzles connected to the pipe manifold. The water is sprinkled in fine jet through nozzles at the height of 2 meter to 2.5 meter, so that water is in contact with air for a longer time. The nozzles are generally operated at a pressure of 0.07 to 0.14 Newton per meter square. The discharge through nozzles will depend upon its design and available head of water. So these are the types of spray nozzles. As you can see, the water is spray in the form of jet action, so that it will get contact in air for the longer duration. This is the image of spray nozzles. So again, there are different types comes under spray nozzles or spray aerator. So first is aeration by nozzle. Second is by air stripping. So what is air stripping? It is quite effective in removing volatile organic chemicals if present in water. Volatile organic chemicals may be carcinogenic. For example, VOCs are benzene from gasoline and trichloroethylene from dry cleaning establishment. So sometimes in water which contains the volatile organic matters or chemicals. And it can be accomplished by letting the water flow over the cascade aerator or in specially designed air stripping towers. In air stripping towers, water is allowed to fall down over a support medium or packing contained in water tower, while air is being pumped into the bottom of tower. So these are huge height of towers. So again, the types of aeration systems are divided into a diffused air aeration, mechanical aeration, and combined diffused air or mechanical aeration. So these are the methods by which we are applying the aeration to the water treatment, for the water treatment. So first is diffused aerator. What is diffused aerator? A common way to aerate water via diffused air. In these systems, air is pumped through some sort of diffusers to generate small bubbles. These diffusers are porous, ceramic, cloth or plastic. The perforated pipe are installed at the bottom of tank and the compressed air is blown through this pipe. So these are again the types of aerator which are comes under the methodology of passing the air into water. So previous types that we have seen, the mechanism or methodology is the passing water into air. That means water is in contact with air. But this type of aerator, that is diffuse aerator or mechanical aerators, in that aerators, we are diffusing air into the water. So it is based on the methodology that passing air into water. So both the methods are different. So in this method, the air bubbles while coming up from the bottom of the tank comes in close contact with water contained in tank and aeration of water is takes place. Again, the depth of aeration tank is generally about 2.5 to 3 meter and they generally work on principle of continuous flow within a minimum retention period of 15 minutes. The quantity of air consumed per 1000 liter of water varies from 0.3 meter cube to 0.6 meter cube. So we are providing this amount of air per 1000 liter of water. So this is nothing but aeration rate. Again, the types of diffuse aerator are fine bubbles, coarse bubbles, and efficiency of fine bubble aeration is 10 to 20 times greater than that of coarse bubble diffuse aerator. So that types are depending on its porous sides, pore sides of the diffusers. So these are the air diffusion aerators. As you can see, this is the rectangular tank. The raw water coming is from this inlet and air dispersed by the porous plate. So this is the horizontal and vertical porous plate in form of fine coarse and coarse fine or coarse pores in this pipe, and from this we are providing the air or diffuse the air into this water. So bubble formation is there and gas transfer mechanism is there. So advantages of diffuse aeration technology are: it is a high oxygen transfer rate, it is simple installation, lower energy cost required, capable of being connected to both round and square pipe, and fully flooded pipe made with eco-friendly polypropylene. So overall cost is reduced and available in usable length of up to 2 meters. Next type are mechanical aerator. The mechanical aerators are of two types, the surface aerator and turbine aerator. Surface aerator consists of submerged or partially submerged impellers which are centrally mounted in the aeration tank. The surface aerator agitates the wastewater vigorously, entraining air in the wastewater and causing the rapid change of air-water interface to facilitate solution of air. So generally these mechanical aerators are providing when we are treating a huge amount of wastewater or a water. So most of wastewater plant we are seeing these kind of aerator systems. And second one is turbine aerator. Turbine aerators are usually upflow type that rely on violent agitations of surface and air entrainment for their efficiency. A draft tube may be utilized to control the flow pattern of circulating liquid within the aeration tank. The draft tube is a cylinder with flared ends mounted concentrically with the impeller and extending from just above the floor of aeration tank to just beneath the impeller. So again, these type of mechanism are comes under the methodology of passing air in water. So these are the kind of mechanical aerator. As you can see, the vertical impeller is provided. So, what is the difference between diffused aeration and mechanical aeration? in form of mixing. Diffused aerators are superior mixing in nature, and mechanical aerations are limited mixing depth is there. Under diffuse aerator, full mixing for any depth and full basin utilization, but in mechanical aerator, limited energy location is required and the poor distribution of gas transfer. In diffuse aeration system, the major energy saving approximately 40% in energy saving and low energy demand. But in mechanical aerator, the high energy cost is there and high energy demand is required. In diffuse aerator, there is possibility, it is the possible flexibility and can come down or total entire system. But in mechanical aeration system, the loss of air when units are turned off and no throttling possible. The capital cost of diffused aeration systems are it used in deep basin, so it is economical and short payback period is there. But the mechanical aeration, because of deep basins required and which are very costly, and it is comparatively high payback period. And there are some common operating problems faced under mechanical aerator, such as supersaturation, slow removal of hydrogen sulfide, algae production, clog filters, and overuse of energy. So these are the general or common problems we are facing under the aeration systems. So summarize this whole unit that we have seen. The definition of aeration, the mechanism of aeration, different types of aeration systems, methods of applying the aeration, and the problem facing in aeration systems. Thank you.